The name of my topic is marine biotechnology. It is also known as blue biotechnology. So what is the simple meaning or the definition of marine biotechnology? The studying of all the marine resources by using biotechnological tools and techniques is called as marine biotechnology. So we use marine biotechnology in different sectors. Here are 7 sectors in which marine biotechnology has wide application. So the first one is oncology. Oncology is related to study of cancer. We all know that cancer is one of the most lethal disease in worldwide. So in the formation of anti-cancer drug, we mainly use marine bacteria. For example, bryostatin and sarcodictin, these are the most effective anti-cancer drug produced mainly by marine bacteria. Second one is immunology. Immunology is something which is related to our present health. If we are susceptible to any disease, we take different type of medicine. So in the formation of this medicine, we use marine resources. For example, cytarabine and ziconotide are used in pharmaceutical product. Third one is in tissue engineering. In tissue engineering field, we use marine resources. Fourth one is aquaculture. Aquaculture, it is also known as aqua farming. Farming of aquatic organisms like fish, molluscs and aquatic plant is done in aquaculture. Next one is environmental technology. Marine resources is one of the most important part of environment, and therefore this marine resources are also used in environmental technology. Next is tourism and shipbuilding. These are the sectors in which marine biotechnology is used. So how we can use these marine resources at industry level or in agriculture level? We all know that in industry and agriculture, marine biotechnology are providing us environmental friendly pesticides and biofertilizers. So these environmental friendly pesticides and biofertilizers are beneficial for environment and beneficial for earth too. For example, cyanobacteria is used in the production of biofertilizers. Cyanobacteria is used in the formation of biofertilizer because the amount of CO2 which is produced by cyanobacteria is very less, and it is beneficial for environment and for human health also. We can produce fuels from algae. Algae is one of the most important marine resources, and by using algae we can produce biofuels. Biofuels which is produced by algae produce very less amount of CO2 as compared to fossil fuels. One of the alga known as Juneliella can produce glycerol, and by converting glycerol by using chemicals on it, we can produce ethanol and butanol, which can also be used as fuels. Seaweed can also use as fuel. We can produce methane by anaerobic digestion, by fermentation. Red seaweed, it is also one important seaweed which consists of carrageenan. It also can be used for the production of bioethanol. There are some algal products which have a wide application. First one is, so there are two types of algae, macroalgae and microalgae. So the first one is macroalgae. Seaweed is a macroalgae. Uses of seaweed is, we can use it as a food, as biofertilizer, or in the bioethanol production. We can culture it by using callus tissue culture technique or by protoplast fusion. Second one is microalgae. Green algae and cyanobacteria are the examples of microalgae. They are used as food or used as pigment sources such as beta carotene. Algae like spirulina and chlorella have high nutritive value, so they are used in fish food and in Japanese food. Here are two pictures are given of algal food products. So what is the future of marine biotechnology as it related to agriculture and industry? Future of marine biotechnology has wide scope. Scientists in the field of marine biotechnology are studying various enzymes and proteins of marine life in hope of solving many problems which is related to area of agriculture and industry today. This problem also include trying to find ideas related to anti-corrosive coatings and self-cleaning surfaces for industrial use. As The future of marine biotechnology has wide scope. There are some challenges which is faced by marine biotechnology. First one is biosafety. For the production of biopesticides or biofertilizers or biofuels, we require different type of marine resources. So we can't kill them or we can't use for them for our beneficial purpose. So the first important challenge faced by marine biotechnology is related to their safety, which is known as biosafety. Second one is access to marine organism and resources. And third one is intellectual property rights. There are some laws or there are some rights under which we can use them. Without hurting that laws or that rights, we can use them. And some of the people are using these resources in a bad way. So these are the three most important challenges faced by marine biotechnology. So here is the all introductory part of marine biotechnology. Thank you.